Hello, my friend. Have you ever heard about the wisdom says from the womb of suffering, the success is born? Today, I would like to talk. My speech is about a Palestinian refugee called now Professor Talal. Professor Talal, which has I'm inspiring him, and he's influenced me in every time I listen. I'm listening to his speeches and conferences. The man who was built an intellectual and educational and financial empire. The first thing that I would like to point out about is his childhood, how he started and how he moved from country to country. He was born to a Boer family in 1938, and then he moved to Lebanon as a refugee with his parents in 1948 in the age of 10, which was a blessing to him that in spite of everything, that is a place of suffering, which made him a challenger. This word is said by him. Let me elaborate about his childhood. He was working and studying in the same time. He was working 4 hours to go, walking 4 hours to go to the nearest school to his house. He said when he was going and back to school, he was reviewing his lessons and thinking about his future since he was a child. When he was a child, he also was working in an ice cream factory. He stated that he loves his work because he was earning money, and the factory providing him with free of charge ice cream. Also, he was working in a musical shop, and he studied classical music, which he greatly loves. In addition, the eager beaver guy enrolled in university, which is in which within scholarship found by UN, because he was not able to enroll the university. At that time, he got the only seat in the university for the student who gets the highest mark all over Lebanon, just for one seat in American University in Beirut. He said in one of his speeches that he was collecting the fruit in lunch and breakfast and dinner just to take him in the weekend to cheer him with his family. So you can imagine how his family was poor. The third point I'd like to talk about, while he's still undergraduate, he worked as a translator from Arabic to English. And the first, after graduation, the first job he got, it was in audit firm. After 100 attempts of getting a job, the final point I would like to say it, it's how the idea came to him. In 1969, upon hearing a speech in a lecture, upon hearing a lecture on intellectual property in San Francisco, he decided to launch his, started his career in a field of IP rights. IP rights is things like when you own something and you want to put protect on it. But he lost everything during the war in Kuwait. Then he starts over again from zero, and he never stopped developing his work. And now his empire stretching about 101 offices around the world, and he got about 4 decorates, honorary decorates from prestigious university. In my conclusion, professor drew up a plan. And he put a target in front of his eyes. Now he's become a figure, international figure of his activity and scientific and logical thinking. and hit the faith in education as a fundamental power of the development. Thank you for listening.